morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning, y'all. Come on in. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Hallelujah. 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 Y'all come on in. Come on in. There will be glory after this. There will be victory after this. What is after this? Whatever you're going through, amen? Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. This is the day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Good morning, man. Listen. Of course, I have a word today that I believe is truly going to be a blessing to y'all. And, you know, this morning I'm going to talk about comparison. You know, all of us are guilty of comparing ourselves. You know, the way we look, the shape of our nose, our weight, our height, the clothes we wear. You know, all of us are guilty of comparing ourselves to other people. All of us are. But the problem with comparison is, when we compare ourselves, you know, to other people and how other people look and what other people have, what we're saying to God is that, God, you made somebody better than me. That's basically what we're saying to God. It may sound pretty strong to make that statement, but the reality of it is when we compare ourselves and we feel like other people look better than us, they're smarter than us, all of those things. Basically, we're saying, God, you made somebody better than me. And of course, you know, we'll see in the word that that's not true. So what I want to talk about this morning is, what is the cure for comparison? What is the cure? How do I address comparison? How do I deal with comparing myself to other people in life? And that's what we're going to talk about this morning. Good morning. I'm so happy to see everybody coming on. I want to say a special good morning to Gene Kerr. I see that you're on, Brother Gene Kerr. Boss man, big up. Much respect to you. Happy belated birthday. I think your birthday was yesterday or Thursday. I'm not sure. I think it was yesterday, which was Saturday or Friday. But big ups to you, Brother Gene Kerr. Boss man, love you, man. God bless you. Listen. We're going to go ahead and get into the word. We're going to go ahead and get into the word. So listen, get your Bible out, man. I want you guys to get your word out, get your sword out, get your Bible out, and follow along with me in this teaching message so that you can see the revelation for yourself, so that the word can come alive in your life and in your heart and in your spirit. So get your Bible out, share the video with someone. You know, invite somebody to jump on. Why? Because God wants you to win. And God wants you to win this morning over comparison. He wants you to stop comparing yourself. He wants you to stop looking at yourself as less than. And that's what he wants you to do. Ultimately, God wants us to win in life. His word constantly tells us that. And so let's go to Matthew, the book of Matthew, chapter 16. And I'm going to read verses 13 through 17 in the New International Version of the Bible. So listen, you guys, I want you guys to get your word out and follow along with me, because I'm telling you, this is going to be one of those teaching messages that is kind of like an aha moment. You know, you have that aha moment, like, I got it. So Matthew chapter 16, verses 13 through 17. The word of God says this: when Jesus came to the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others say Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." Jesus replied, "But what about you?" he asked, "Who do you say I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus replied, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for this was not revealed to you by man, but by my Father in heaven." So this morning, we're going to be teaching from Matthew chapter 16, verses 13 through 17. we're talking about the cure for comparison. How do we cure the issue of comparison? How do we stop or at least minimize comparing ourselves to other people, comparing our lives to other people? So think about it. Some of the most heated conversations or comparisons are related to the sports world. Who's better, Michael Jordan or LeBron James or Kobe Bryant? Was Wilt Chamberlain better than Kareem Abdul-Jabbar? Was Magic Johnson better than Larry Bird? Our society seems to be infatuated with comparisons. But what we must do and what we must understand that we should never fall into the trap of comparing who we are to someone else. You have to understand that God made you to be you and not anyone else. I know it's hard. As I said before, all of us are victims. All of us are guilty of comparison. But listen to this quote. I want you to listen to this quote real quick. And if you can write it down, write it down. Here it is. Life isn't about being better than someone else, but life is about being your best you. If someone can remember that and type that quote in, I want you to hold on to that quote when you start thinking about comparing yourself and comparing your life to someone else's life. Remember this quote. Life isn't about being better than someone else, but life is about being your best you. That's what life is all about. Life is not about being someone else, but life is all about being your best you. Here's another quote. I want you guys, someone please type this in for me. Every minute you spend wishing you had someone else's life is a minute spent wasting your life. Think about that for a moment. Every minute you spend wishing you had someone else's life is a minute spent wasting your life. If someone can type those two quotes in there for me, I would greatly appreciate it, because those two quotes are really, 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 they really hit the nail on the head when it comes to comparison. Here's another one real quick. The fastest way to destroy something special is to compare it to something else. The fastest way to destroy something special is to compare it to something else. The fastest way to destroy your relationship is to compare it to somebody else's relationship. The fastest way to destroy your marriage is to compare your marriage to someone else's marriage. That's what comparison does. And so when you compare your life to someone else's life, comparison, watch this, will then demand that one or the other is found less than, because comparison is all about who's better or who's the best. That's why comparison is so dangerous. That's why comparison is so unhealthy. I'm going to read that again. When you compare your life to someone else's life, comparison then will demand that one or the other is found less than, because comparison is all about who's better or who's the best. In other words, when you compare your life to someone else's, at that point you start to diminish your life, and at the end of that comparison, you have to figure out who's better, who's best. And so if God doesn't compare us, then why do we compare ourselves? Romans chapter 2, verse number 11 says this, "For God does not show favoritism." In other words, God sees us all the same. He does not compare us. But yet and still, we are obsessed with comparisons. We're obsessed with comparison. We compare our careers to other people's careers. We compare our relationships to other people's relationships. We compare our spouses to other people. We compare our children to other people's children. We compare our church to other people's church. We compare our pastors to other pastors. And it's all about understanding that when you start comparing yourself, you are putting yourself in a dangerous place where you are starting to impact your self-esteem, your self-worth, your self-value. And so that's why comparison is so dangerous. And this is what is going on in our text in Matthew chapter 16, verses 13 through 17. The people in the region of Caesarea Philippi were comparing Jesus to others that they thought he was. They were comparing him to John the Baptist. They were comparing him to Elijah. They were comparing him to Jeremiah. They were comparing him to so-called other prophets. And so Jesus addresses this issue of comparison by asking his disciples, "Who do you say I am?" I know that the people in Caesarea Philippi are comparing me to everybody else, but who do you say I am? Watch this, y'all. Watch this. Jesus asked this question so that he could put an end to this comparison within the mind and the hearts of his disciples. He wanted his disciples to be very clear on who he was. And he needed them to understand that the people that were comparing him had no clue of who he was. Now watch this. In our text, I want to look at what I call the cure for comparison. I want to look at what I call the cure for comparison. Because the spirit of comparison, when you compare yourself to someone else, will rob you, again, of your self-confidence, your self-worth, your self-esteem, your self-value. Whenever you start thinking that someone is better than you, or someone is more intelligent than you, or someone is more smarter than you, or someone has a better life than you, you are then tearing down your self-confidence. You are then destroying your self-worth. You are then destroying your self-esteem. And so Jesus reveals to us these three principles that allow us to understand that there is a cure for comparison. There's a cure for comparison. Here are three life lessons. Here are three life principles. Here are three points that will help you begin to cure your issue of comparison. Three principles that will help you cure your issue as it relates to comparison. Now here it is. Watch this. Number one, someone type this in. Here are the three life lessons. Here are the three points that are the cure for comparison. Someone type this in. Number one, purpose. Somebody type that in for me. Purpose. When we talk about understanding the cure for comparison, the first life principle you need to understand, number one, is purpose. Someone type that in for me. Now watch this. Let's go to the scriptures. Let's look at the word of God. Watch this. Matthew chapter 16. Let's look at verse number 13. Here it is. Watch this. When Jesus came to the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say?" Now underline these words. "The Son of Man is." Underline those words. "The Son of Man is." So when we talk about having a cure for comparison, the first life lesson, the first life principle is purpose. Number one, purpose. Why do I say that? Watch this. Underline this word, these words. "The Son of Man is." Jesus asked the question. He says, "Who do people say the Son of Man is?" Now watch this. One of the things that will keep you from comparing yourself to other people in life is to know your purpose in life. I'm telling you, watch this, man. Y'all got to get this. When Jesus uses this term, the Son of Man, he is revealing to his disciples that he knows who he is and why he was born. He calls himself the Son of Man because he was birthed or he came through a woman, right? But watch this. This phrase, the word of man, the Son of Man in this phrase actually means something. When Jesus says, "Who do people say the Son of Man is?" This phrase, the Son of Man, does not mean male gender. When Jesus says, "Who do people say the Son of Man is?" And who do people say that the Son of Man is? Watch this. He's not talking about male gender. Jesus was stating that he was brought into the world through a virgin because it was foretold in the scriptures that the virgin would give birth to the Messiah. And the Messiah's purpose was to save the world. So when Jesus says, who do people say the Son of Man is, Jesus was basically speaking to his purpose. Jesus was basically saying, I know who I am. I know what my purpose is. I know why I was born. I know why I was brought into this earth. See, watch this. When you know your purpose, you don't compare yourselves to other people. One of the main reasons why we compare ourselves to other people is because we're not walking in our purpose in life. See, watch this. When you're walking in your purpose in life, you don't have time to be worrying about what someone else has, what someone else is doing, who someone else is. See, your purpose will keep you busy. Your purpose will keep you focused. And see, watch this. What were you born to do? The moment that you figure out what you were born to do is the moment that you stop comparing yourself to other people. I'm telling you, one of the main reasons why people constantly compare themselves to other people is because they don't know their purpose. See, here it is. Watch this. Don't compare your life to others. Watch this. There's no comparison between the sun and the moon. They both have their own purpose. See, the sun is not sitting here saying, boy, I wish I could shine like the moon. The moon is not sitting here saying, boy, I wish I could shine like the sun. No, the sun understands that my job is to bring daylight. The moon understands that my job is to bring light so that it is not pitch dark. So watch this. We won't be distracted by comparison if we tap into what our purpose is in life. See, watch this, y'all. Y'all got to get this. Y'all have to get this. Let me tell you something. One of the things that keeps me from comparing myself to other pastors and other preachers and other teachers of the Word of God is because I have tapped into what my purpose is. My purpose in teaching the Scriptures and teaching the Word of God is to teach people how to win in life. I understand that very clearly. God has allowed me to understand that my purpose as a teacher, as a preacher, as a pastor, is to teach people how to win in life. And so that's what I focus on. That's what I do. Why? Because God wants you to win. So watch this. I used to compare my sermons to other pastors' sermons. I used to compare my preaching style to other preachers' style. But I don't do that anymore. I used to, but I don't do it anymore. Because when God began to reveal to me what my purpose was in the kingdom, what my purpose was as a pastor, what my purpose was as a teacher, it allowed me to stop comparing myself. So watch this. When you understand your purpose in life, you will begin to cure yourself from comparing yourself. You will begin to walk in the cure from comparing yourself to other people. That's life point, life principle number one. Purpose. When we talk about having a cure for comparison, the first life principle is get to know what your purpose is. Find out what your purpose is. Understand what your purpose is, because that will begin to cure you from comparing yourself. Here's number two, y'all. Someone type this in for me. Here's the second life lesson. Here's the second principle. People. Someone type that in for me. People. See, when Jesus asked his disciples this question in verse number 13, he is basically letting us know that we shouldn't worry about what everybody else thinks of us. See, watch this. He wants us to understand that it only matters that those connected to us know who we are. Man, y'all got to get this, man. Y'all, oh my God, y'all got to get this. Watch this. Let me read it to you again. Verse number 13. When Jesus came to the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked the disciples, underline this, who do people say the Son of Man is? And so the second principle, the second life principle to the cure for comparison is people. Somebody type that in for me. The first cure is understanding your purpose. The second cure is understanding people. Now watch this. Stop wasting valuable time and valuable energy trying to make sure that everyone likes you, that everyone knows who you are, that everyone knows your heart. When these people were comparing Jesus, it was because they didn't know who Jesus was. And watch this. They didn't know who he was because they didn't take the time to get to know him. Stop worrying about people comparing you. Stop comparing yourself to people. Let people who are committed to misunderstanding who you are think what they want to think about you. And stop thinking that it is a good thing, that it's a good thing that everyone speaks well of you. You see, when we compare ourselves to other people, most times it's because we see that a lot of people like that person, or that person is famous, or that person is well known. But you have to be set free from people and what people think. And Jesus shows us that the reality of it is this: the only people that really matter, the only people that you should really be concerned with, are the people that are connected to you. You see, comparing yourself is all about, I'm not going to say all about, but comparing yourself to other individuals and their lives and what they have and what they do is because you see how people respond to them. You see how people like them. Think about it. Take social media, for example. When you compare how many likes you get to somebody else's likes, when you compare how many friends you have to somebody else's friends, when you compare how many followers you have versus how many followers someone else has, when someone else has more followers or more friends or more likes, you start comparing, well, I guess they're more known than I am. I guess they're more, I don't know. I guess they're better than me because they have all of these followers, all of these likes. But the reality of it is this: when you get set free from people and what people think and what people feel about you, you will stop comparing yourselves. You should not allow somebody's like to determine who you are. You should not allow who follows you to determine who you are. You should not allow how many people that follow you determine who you are. Because think about it. When you allow that to dictate and you start comparing yourself, you are now worrying about what people think. That's what you're doing. So Jesus says, he says, listen, I need you to understand something about people. See, watch this. Y'all got to get this. Stop thinking that it's a good thing that everyone speaks well of you. That's why the scripture says in Luke chapter number 6, verse number 26, woe to you when everyone speaks well of you. See, people think that people dictate who's important or who's popular or who's more successful. And like I said, in social media, when people have millions of followers, immediately you compare yourself and say, oh, well, they're better than I am. The devil is a liar. That doesn't make them better than you. Just be thankful and connected to the people that you're connected to. And so here's the cure for comparison. Here's how you stop comparing yourself to other people. Number one, understand your purpose. Number two, stop worrying about people. And then number three, perception. Perception. Someone type this in for me. Perception. Here it is right here, y'all. Verse number 15. But what about you? Jesus asked his disciples. Who do you say I am? Underline that. Who do you say I am? See, here is the third life principle. Here is the third point. Here it is. Watch this, y'all. Perception. When we talk about being cured for comparison, when we talk about how to stop ourselves from comparing ourselves to other people, here's the third life lesson. Here's the third point. Perception. See, watch this. In verse number 15, when Jesus says, who do you say I am? Listen to this. Jesus was basically saying, I don't care what people say. I don't care about what people think. I want to know what your perception of me is. Man, did y'all get that? Did y'all get that? Jesus was saying to his disciples, he says, I know what people are saying. I ain't thinking about what people are saying. I'm not worrying about what people are saying. I want to know what's your perception of me. You guys are connected to me. You guys are following me. You guys are my disciples. What is your perception of me? Now watch this, watch this, watch this, watch this, watch this. Jesus wanted us to understand that most people compare us based on their perception of us. In other words, they based us how they see us, how they view us. Jesus was checking to see what was the perception of the disciples and who they thought he was. He wanted to know that they know who he was. It's not that he didn't know, but it was for them to know that they knew so that they could walk in confidence. Jesus says, listen, if you guys know who I am, you'll walk in confidence. If you guys know who I am, you'll walk in faith. If you know who I am, you'll trust me. So when we talk about the cure for comparison, your perception of yourself is how your confidence or lack of confidence is born. Your perception of yourself is how your confidence or your lack of confidence is born. How you see yourself, how you view yourself, determines how confident you are. And if you see yourself the way God sees you, then you have confidence in who you are and you stop comparing yourself to other people. Now watch this. Y'all got to get this. Y'all got to get this. Somebody try to type this in for me if you can. Your perception of yourself will determine if you compare yourself to others. Your perception of yourself. Now think about it. Jesus knew who he was. His perception of himself was clear. The other people who thought he was John the Baptist, who thought he was Jeremiah, who thought he was Isaiah, their perception of him was totally wrong. Totally off the mark. So watch this. Because Jesus' perception of himself was accurate, he shows us that your perception of yourself will determine if you compare yourself to others. Jesus never compared himself to other people. He never compared himself to other people. How do you see yourself? That is the question. What is your perception of yourself? See, my perception of who I am comes from the scriptures. That's where my perception comes from. See, I am fearfully and wonderfully made. That's what Psalm 139 and 14 tells me. See, I was created in the image of God. That's what Genesis 1 and 26 tells me. See, watch this. A flower does not think of competing with the flower next to it. It just blooms. It just blooms. See, in other words, be who you are. Understand. Have the right perception of yourself. Because watch this. Someone is secretly wishing that they were you. Someone is secretly wishing that they had your life. So be yourself, baby. Be your best you. You are not competing with anyone in this world. Your job is to strive to walk in purpose and be the best you and the best version of you that you can be. See, watch this, watch this, watch this. Y'all have to get this. Y'all have to get this. Y'all have to get this. Your perception of who you are determines if you compare yourself to other people. I'm telling you. See, that's why you've got to be clear on who you are and what you're all about. You got to be clear. You have to be clear. Listen, I don't know who this message was for this morning. I don't know who's struggling with the issue of comparison. I don't know who's struggling with low self-esteem. I don't know who's struggling with self-worth and self-value. Stop thinking that you're stupid because someone else seems to be smarter than you. Stop thinking that you don't have anything because someone has more than you. Stop thinking that you're not beautiful because of glamour shots on social media. People are showing you their glamour shots. People are showing you the highlight reels of their life. And you're comparing yourself to those false things. See, here's the cure. Here is the cure for comparison. Here is how you stop comparing yourself to other people. Number one, understand your purpose. Number two, have the proper understanding about people. And then number three, understand and have the proper perception about yourself. Purpose, people, perception. That is how you cure the issue of comparing yourself to other people. You are beautiful in the sight of God. You are precious in the sight of God. God gave his only son for you. God didn't say, oh, these people are better, these people are smarter, these people are more prettier, these people are more intelligent, so I'm only going to let Jesus die for them. No, his son died for you. That means you're somebody. That means you're precious in his sight. Listen, stop letting people's words defeat your perception of who you are. Get delivered from what somebody called you when you were 9 years old. Get delivered from your very own mom or your very own dad saying you're never going to be anyone. That's why we have a heavenly Father. And we get our identity through Christ. So I don't know who this message was for this morning, but I pray that something that I share was a blessing to you. Let us pray. Father, we just thank you for this message today. I pray, oh God, that this word has fallen, this seed has fallen on fertile soil. And I pray, oh God, that it will bring forth fruit, and I pray that it will bless your people to get the victory and to win over comparing their lives to other people. I thank you, God, that you said in your word that you want us to win. You said in your word, Lord God, that thanks be to Christ who gives us the victory. God, we thank you for victory through your word and in your word. Bless the people on this live, oh God. Deliver them from comparing themselves, comparing their lives, comparing their children to other people. God, I pray that they will get the victory today. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, listen, God bless y'all. I pray that this message was a blessing to you. And listen, I know for a fact that all of us have been or currently are guilty of comparing our lives to other people. And I just thank God that he delivered me from comparing myself and my life to other people. God wants you to win. God wants you to win. God wants you to be the best you. God wants you to be the best version of you. And so that starts with you. Stop comparing yourself. Listen, if you're on this live today and you have never accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, that means if you've never been born again, that means if you've never invited Jesus Christ in your heart. Listen, I want to lead you to Christ this morning, not to a church, not to a denomination, and not to religion. I want to lead you in a relationship. And so if you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, I just want you to type in right now, I want Jesus. type it in right now. If you're watching and you don't know Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, just type in, I want Jesus. Or just type in Jesus. What does that mean? What does salvation mean? What does born again mean? What does being saved mean? It simply means that we do what Romans 10 verses 1 through 17 says. We confess with our mouth that we need a Savior. We believe in our heart that Jesus Christ is God in the flesh, that he was born to save us from our sins, and that he suffered, bled, and died, and shed his blood to give us eternal life. And we believe that by faith, and we accept it, and we invite Jesus in our heart. We get born again. We're saved. That's what it means. It's a simple prayer. If you want to get born again, if you want Jesus, just simply type in Jesus right now. I'll give you a few minutes just to do it as we prepare to just give and go about having an amazing Sunday. Amen? So listen, I thank God for you guys tuning in with me today. I thank God for you guys joining in with me on this live today. I pray that you were blessed. At this time, I'm going to ask you to give. Give, 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 give. Give, give. The Bible says, give, and it shall be given unto you, pressed down, running over, men shall give into your bosom. Man, let me tell y'all something. I take joy in giving. The Bible even says that God loves a cheerful giver. So I know God loves me because I am a cheerful giver. I don't give and be like, oh, God, that's going to hurt me. I don't give and be like, man, I wish I didn't have to give that money. I don't give it and be like, man, I shouldn't have gave that. No, I give it. And then I say, Lord, bless me with more so I can give more. I'm a cheerful giver. And God blesses a cheerful giver. So Beverly has put on the live all of the different ways that you can give through Cash App, through our website, and through PayPal. So all of those ways that you can give are on there right now. Give, 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 y'all. I'm telling you, give and you shall receive. I'm telling you, I'm telling you, I'm telling you. That's how you get blessed financially. So take this time now to give through one of these different avenues that you can give, one of these different ways that you can give, through PayPal, our webpage, or through Cash App. Listen, I love you. God bless you, Gene Kerr. Love you, brother. Much respect to you, sir. Happy birthday again. God bless you, Toby. I see you, Toby. God bless you. Marjorie. God bless you, Marjorie. Love you, guys. Love you, love you, love you. Listen, have a blessed Sunday, rest of your day. Go in the Lord, go in the strength of the Lord, and get the victory over comparing yourself and comparing your life to others. God wants you to win, and that's why he gave you this word today. Listen, people, perception, and purpose. When you understand those three principles, it will give you the victory over comparing your life. God bless you. I love you. And listen, I will see you again real soon. God bless you.